Take note of the easements applicable to the banks of rivers and streams. As I mentioned a while earlier, these have been modified by Article 51 and 52 of the Water Code. So, under Article 51 of the Water Code, the width of the area covered by the easement for the benefit of recreation, navigation, flotage, fishing, and salvage. Please take note, kasama ang recreation. Okay? The area depends upon the location. So, in urban areas, the width of the easement is only 3 meters. In agricultural areas, the width is much wider, 20 meters. And in forest areas, the width is actually 40 meters. Easement of right of way, paborito rin ito, mga kasama. Remember, you can demand an easement of right of way if your estate has no adequate outlet to a public street or highway because it is surrounded by other immovables belonging to other persons. The outlet to a public highway must be an adequate outlet. In this connection, in one case, it has been held by the Supreme Court, where the outlet to a public highway is through a riverbed. Okay? A dry riverbed. That is not considered an adequate outlet. Why? Eh, during the rainy season, hindi ka makadaan dun. Okay? Maaring during the dry season, pag may El Nino, dry yan. Yung dry yung riverbed. Pero pag nag-uulan na, eh, wala ka ng outlet niyan. So it's not considered an adequate outlet. I refer to the case of Encarnacion versus Court of Appeals. Okay? Alright. As long as there is an outlet, however, even if it is a very inconvenient outlet, alimbawa, baku-baku yung daan, at pagtagulan, maputik. Okay? So it's an ordeal traversing the outlet. That is still considered an adequate outlet. And therefore, you cannot demand a right-of-way through another estate. Okay? So, mere inconvenience does not justify the demand for a right-of-way. As long as there is already an outlet, even if very inconvenient to use. What is the indemnity to be paid to the owner of the servant estate? If it is a permanent right-of-way, the indemnity to be paid will have to be the value of the land occupied by the passage plus any consequential damages. If it is not a permanent road, simply involves walking through the property of another, then the indemnity will simply be the, well, whatever damage may be caused to the servant estate as a consequence of the passage. In determining where the right-of-way will pass through the servant estate, remember that there are two factors to consider. distance and amount of damage or prejudice to the servant estate. Between the two, the one which should be given preference is the factor of the amount of damage. In one case, a right of way had to be established through the servant estate. If a straight path or road will be taken to the public highway, that will involve the demolition of a sari-sari store or a building. If the right of way will take a longer route, however, it will involve the cutting down of an avocado tree. Aba, sabi ng Supreme Court, walang choice yan. Siyempre doon na tayo sa avocado. Okay? Mas least prejudicial yung putulin mo yung avocado tree kesa sasirain mo yung building na yan na masasagasaan kung direct yung linya. So between distance and amount of damage, it is the amount of damage which is given preferential consideration in determining where the right of way will pass. Next point. If the owner of property sells it, okay, and after the sale, he realizes that he is now surrounded by the property he sold. Wala siyang outlet sa public highway. Can he demand the right of way? The answer is yes. Does he have to pay indemnity? Yes. But if he donated it, he can simply demand the right of way. He does not have to pay any indemnity. Bakit? O ba naman, binigay na nga niya yun, dinonate na nga niya yun. Nung nakulong siya, wala siya madaanan, dapat siyempre naman bigyan siya ng libreng right of way. Okay. Reverse situation. I sold property to you. Ha, binenta ko sa iyo, property. Kamukat-mukat mo, yung pala, surrounded by other properties belonging to me. Wala kang outlet sa public highway. Can you demand the right of way? Yes. Do you have to pay indemnity? No. Okay, no, you don't have to pay indemnity. Okay. But supposing that it is not a sale, okay? I donated property to you. Okay? After the donation, you discovered that the property I donated to you is surrounded by other properties belonging to me. Can you demand the right of way? Yes. Do you have to pay indemnity? Siyempre naman. Okay? Donation ito eh. Ha? So you apply different rules to donors and different rules on the other hand to sellers of property. Okay. What is the legal consequence? If after a right of way has been constituted, demanded and constituted, the government opens another public road in such a way that the servant estate now has another direct access to a public street or road. Is the easement over the servant estate, which was earlier created when that new road was not yet in existence, is that automatically terminated? Okay. Halimbawa ito. Halimbawa, nandito ang public street. Okay? So, this is dominant estate. It demanded an easement through this property so that it would have an outlet to public street. Later on, the government constructed another road here. So, hindi niya kailangan yun. Meron na siyang direct access. The question is, will this easement of right-of-way be automatically terminated? The answer is no. It will not be automatically terminated. It will only be terminated if desired by the owner of the Serbian estate. The option is given to the owner of the Serbian estate. Depende yan kay Mr. B, the owner of the Serbian estate, kung gusto niyang i-terminate yung easement of right of way. Of course, if Mr. B decides to have that easement of right of way terminated, he will have to return the earlier indemnity which he had received from Mr. A. Okay. Walang interest yun, but he has to return the indemnity. So maybe that's one reason why the owner of the Serbian estate may not want to terminate the easement. Oh, earlier, nagdi-demand-demand ka ng easement dito. Yan. Sige, gamitin mo. Okay? It's not automatically terminated. It depends upon the will of the Serbian estate. The owner of the dominant estate cannot demand the termination of the easement. That option is granted only to the owner of the Serbian estate under Article 655 of the Civil Code. Easement of party wall. Basically, this is the easement. If there is a dividing wall between two estates, presumption, that's a party wall. In an easement of party wall, which is the dominant estate, which is the Serbian estate? The Serbian estate is the party wall itself. The dominant estates are the two adjoining owners. Okay? So, there is always a presumption whenever there is a dividing wall between two estates that that wall is a party wall. Unless, of course, there are external signs which would indicate that it is not actually a party wall. For example, if the wall is standing exclusively, entirely on the lot of one of the parties, nasa lote lang niya nakatayo yan, that's not a party wall. Okay? If it is straight on one side and plumb on the other, kanino ang presumption doon ng ownership? Doon sa party, on whose side it is plumb.